Hello, this is Matt on the Moon Family Sedan channel. Them splishy splashy whales been getting aquatic AF. And how do I know? Because they've been buying themselves some damn XRP. Look at this headline from You Today. 1.1 billion XRP recently bought by whales. Here's what's happening. You know, it's almost like they kind of know that XRP is going to go on an insane run. Or at least they firmly believe that's going to be the case, right? And it's so fascinating seeing this and understanding that the splishy splashy whales getting aquatic AF. They tend to behave substantially differently than the typical retail lemmings out there who make important buying and selling decisions based on their feels. And also, by the way, have some interesting stats surrounding XRP activity for Q2 now that we are into the third quarter of the year. Man, this year's flying by. And also, I want to share with you a very interesting chart having to do with just general adoption, specifically with Bitcoin, which leads the market. But the concepts shared within that chart, absolutely, so far as I'm concerned, 100% applies to XRP. But the reason I want to highlight it is because it visually shows, it does a great job just visually illustrating how early we actually are. And it's easy to feel like, especially if you just jumped into crypto this year, it's easy to feel like you're late to the party. And let me assure you, let a little bit of time pass and you're going to recognize, nope, that ain't true. It just feels that way if you're just now jumping in. You know, I mean, I remember jumping in 2017 into crypto and I was like, man, I wish I was here sooner. And I still wish I had been there sooner a little bit, but a lot of it. But it doesn't actually matter. You know, I did recognize even back then, party's only getting started, son. So kudos to you all for being here and paying attention, because almost no one on the planet has ever held any crypto for any period of time. But before going further, I do want to be clear. I do not have a financial background of any kind. I am not offering financial advice, and you definitely should not buy or sell anything because of anything I say or write. I'm just an enthusiast who enjoys making YouTube videos about crypto-related topics, but just as a hobby and just for fun. All right, and so this piece states here, and by the way, they're referencing data from Santiment, which is a fantastic on-chain analytics firm. Big fan of them. And so piece reads as follows. Citing Santiment data, crypto analyst Ali reports a whopping 1.1 billion XRP worth around $570 million acquired by whales since February. XRP whales have been regularly buying since the beginning of 2023, frequently taking advantage of periods of decline or consolidation to boost their holdings. Exactly, and that's why I was saying at the outset of the video, they're behaving differently than the typical lemming retail speculator. That is because that is not what the typical speculator does. Oh, price going down. Well, I better get out before it goes even lower. Well, price is up substantially than where compared to where it was a year ago. Man, I better buy right now. That's how you buy the tippy top and then things plummet. But this is how it goes. But it's so fascinating seeing how many whales have been purchasing substantial quantities of XRP. And, you know, if you look at the state of things, how things have unfolded with XRP, it has been fantastic. So 2022, a little bit of a dumpster fire year in terms of price action. All the nonsense, the collapse, you know what happened. I don't even need to tell you guys. FTX, everything else. But Messari did a report, and I think on the whole, it's pretty damn good. And I'm not going to go through it. It's very long, but I thought I'd share with you a few bullet points, which they cited as the most key insights here. And so they noted the following. XRP's circulating market cap is up 42.5% year to date, primarily due to Q1's surge. However, the market cap decreased 10.7% quarter over quarter from $27.8 billion to $24.8 billion in Q2. Yeah, and so I just wanted to note here, first of all, obviously fantastic that year to date, XRP's up 42.5%. Especially considering at the the tail end of 2020, a lot of very well-known and very popular voices in the world of crypto, many were saying that XRP in short order was going to be knocked out of the top 10 cryptos by market cap, which still hasn't happened, despite the fact that the price is artificially suppressed. That's my opinion. It just is, as far as I'm concerned, because of the SEC nonsense here. Now, as far as the decline quarter over quarter, I don't think that matters. Keep in mind, part of the reason that we saw a substantial surge, not just because crypto in general was moving up. Yes, that was a part of it. XRP still moves in tandem with broader crypto markets, albeit at a suppressed level. you know, when we had the Daubert motion settled at the beginning part of March, great ruling from Judge Torres, that's when things really started getting interesting for XRP, in my humble opinion. And, you know, it's not surprising that, you know, that wasn't going to be, I mean, that was a pretty big jump up. That's when we saw ultimately XRP go all the way up to 58 cents. And there was a bit of excitement with the Hinman stuff, and you saw a bit of a price bump with XRP for some period of time. But at this point, we're really just waiting for the conclusion of the damn case. So the fact that that's down and then, you know, Bitcoin's where it is, none of it's particularly surprising. It's just the market moving in tandem. So I just thought I'd mention that. But there's additional adoption and activity. I'm sure that you guys are familiar with XLS20, which was passed last year, providing native functionality, increased native functionality, layer one on the XRP ledger, pertaining specifically to NFTs. This is being substantially adopted. So check this out. Average daily NFT transactions increased 12.7% quarter over quarter from 13,800 to 15,500. Almost all NFT transaction types increased quarter over quarter, and NF token create offer increased its dominance to over 50% of all NFT transactions. So look, I just want to point out that, and this is just in generally how I've been thinking about things pretty much since the beginning. When I jumped into crypto, like, you know, almost 6 years at this point, is that if you look over a long enough period of time, price will follow utility. It's not sufficiently doing that, and, you know, people aren't sufficiently parsing out the differences between crypto, from crypto to crypto today in 2023, because there's too much uncertainty, but I still believe that. And so I just think it's very positive, fantastic to see this increase as it pertains specifically to NFTs, because NFTs are not just some flash in the pan. They're more than just overpriced JPEGs. No, they're not going away. There's real utility to be had with them. You know what? That's sufficient for that. Let's go ahead and jump into this, because I, like I said, at the outset of the video, it's easy to feel like you're late to the party. But you just aren't. There's almost no humans in crypto. It's estimated that like 4% of humans have ever held crypto at any point in time. And this is after about 14 years of crypto existing. 14 years, 4% of humans. Way less than 1% of humans have ever held XRP. So again, congratulations. In fact, you are so early to the party, it's rude, and the host does not appreciate you showing up before they're ready to host. So here's a headline from the Daily HODL. Bitcoin going much higher over the next decade, says on-chain analyst Willy Wu. Here's why. Widely followed on-chain analyst Willy Wu says Bitcoin is going way higher over the next 10 years based on its current state of adoption. Wu tells his 1.1 million Twitter followers that Bitcoin is not even halfway through its adoption S-curve, with the most growth still ahead of it. Yeah, he's definitely right about that. And for those of you that can look at your screen, it's worth it. We got a chart on your screen, and I'll explain it as we go through. Let me just continue with the article a little bit. Again, basically what they did is they have a bell curve, and then they slapped an S curve on top of that. And I mean, basically what they're showing is the same thing, but they're just illustrating the same idea in two different ways. So let me go a little bit further. We'll explain. So S-curves are used to visualize the trajectory of something, in this case, the adoption of a technology, which usually starts off slow before accelerating rapidly and finally reaching an equilibrium. And he said, quote, "Why Bitcoin will outperform in the next decades? Adoption S-curve on money, which is half of everything, currently 4% of world population, it's going much higher." And so you can see where he's pointing here, and this is actually roughly where we'd be at then, and, you know, where I'm circling right here, in terms of actual adoption. If you're talking about going from 0 to 100%, do you see visually how early we are right now? And what's neat is that the rate of adoption increases at an exponential pace. And so it may not be as noticeable right now, but it has been increasing and increasing at an exponential pace for the last 14 years. And it's really gonna ramp up until you hit this inflection point where there's not enough humans on the planet to adopt it, and then the rate slows down. So, but you're so early, you're gonna get to see the ramp up. That's the cool part. And so right here, he's citing Bitcoin. And so it is true of Bitcoin. If you have a very long-term view, Yeah. Bitcoin, if the thesis is correct, yeah, it's going to be worth way, way, way more than it is today. But with XRP, which is, and this is one of the reasons it's more exciting as a holder myself, is that there's way fewer humans in it, way less money in it. So when it goes to, it doesn't take nearly as much money flown in to get a doubling, tripling, quadrupling effect in terms of price action. That is appealing to me. And so when you're looking at the S curve, which is the green curve here, it's just visually showing adoption and the concept of how long it would take, you know, over time, and showing that it increases exponentially. And then you have the bell curve here just showing, and obviously with any bell curve, you know, you have the tails where you have the early, in this case, early adopters, innovators, as they called here, on one side, and then the people who are very slow to change, the laggards, on the other side. So it's really basically just two different ways of illustrating the same concept, and then he's just slapped one on top of the other, which is perfectly fine. But that's why this is so damn exciting here. There are many reasons that I am very excited about crypto literally every single day, specifically XRP, which happens to be my largest hold. This is at the heart of it. I believe that there's so much opportunity for the everyday person to actually achieve life-changing wealth. And most people aren't even paying attention, and too bad, so sad for them, but good on you for paying attention. And it doesn't mean there's not risk, and I think that most people are not going to achieve life-changing wealth for this, but I'm just saying the opportunity is there. It's just that humans kind of are their own worst enemy when it comes to investing, and they use the feels, they use their stupid-ass emotions to make important financial decisions. Maybe don't do that. I'm not telling anyone to buy or sell or hold any, whatever. You do whatever you want to do. I'm not offering financial advice. I'm only suggesting that if you're going to make important financial decisions, don't use your feels, okay? Maybe that's a really bad idea, just generally speaking. But I can't wait to see how the rest of the year unfolds. You know, over halfway through it now, over halfway through the year, we know for sure we've got an exciting conclusion to the SEC v. Ripple case coming, or at least a conclusion from Judge Torres surrounding summary judgment. And that could be the spark that we need to really get things going. And it's in an environment where crypto's been looking pretty damn good this year. So if Bitcoin's ramping up and we have that conclusion, perfect storm type of situation, friends. That's what I'm looking for. That's a big part of what I'm excited about. So we'll see what happens. You know, and I'm always trying to be as realistic as possible. Get it? I could be wrong and it all goes to zero. There obviously is risk associated with all of this. I totally get it. But I still think I'm being pretty reasonable here. It's so early. I am certain that crypto is here to stay. I have zero question as to that. I mean, unless you want to talk about some weird outlier stuff where, you know, we become hit by an asteroid and then cease to exist. Okay, fine. You got me there. Outside of something wacky like that, no. It's not going away. Good times, my friends. I'm not a financial advisor. You should not buy or sell anything because of anything I say or write. That would be a very, very, very bad idea. Until next time. To the Moon Family Sedan.